So we're looking at here the latest Oculus grind in the Crimson Agates. As we can see, we are on the Frostbearing Trees reward page here. The first few levels kind of just give you some rolls, some XP, or more all that. Level 8 is where it does start to get significant though, where you do will get the prototype, but you also unlock the Crimson Wish, which is a daily way to farm out the Crimson Agates without having to hunt down every single last one like we did in the case of the Animoculus and the Geoculus. And we could see here on my Frostbearing tree that I am level 8. I did farm a few extra kind of for no reason just because I lost track of time a bit. But as soon as you get to level 8, on the bottom left, we could see that I have a Crimson Wish 5 for 5, so you could basically get free Crimson Agates, so 5's worth daily, since I did unlock it about an hour and a half ago, and we could see here that it refreshes in 22 or so hours. So this is kind of a daily grind. That symbol that you see in the circle there is the one that's going to pop up on the map. I will have a screenshot of what it looks like on the map, but there will just be 5 locations. What I had to do is I had to clear 5 small mobs, and then I got the agates afterwards. Basically, just do that 5 times a day. It took me a few minutes as opposed to the hour or so, hour and a half. Plus, that it would take you to actually grind out every single Crimson Agate, even with a map. It'll just take you much longer, so it's just more efficient to do it this way. If you want a hard grind, then do it. That's fine too. This is just much easier and it saves a bunch of time since there is a lot of content on Dragonspine so far, and I just prefer to spend time doing that instead. Next, we have the map here. So on it, we can see the Crimson Agate logos. So that's just showing the locations that you need to go to actually get the Crimson Agates that you could farm daily. Like I said before, you just have to kind of kill a mob when it's there. The only thing that I would say about this is that they are sometimes very high up on either columns or on the side of the mountain. So I would TP to a higher location. The higher ones are usually around the center of the mountain. So the closer into the middle you go, the higher you'll be usually. And then to just glide down from there and land on top of the mountain instead of climbing is just a little bit easier, especially since I'm not a huge fan of climbing in itself. After this, we do have the full playthrough of one day's worth of the daily Crimson Agate farming. The whole daily run, so the full clip, is just under 6 minutes long, so that just kind of goes to show how quick you could do it, and that's why I attached it there. I just wanted to give a good idea of how long it would take to grind those daily. So let's say 6, 7 minutes a day, you'll be able to get 5 daily. In a few days, a week or so, you'll be able to unlock the last levels, and you won't really have to worry about farming every single last agate on the map. So that's about it.